Mamma mia, spaghetti. Produce the content, shit out the content. Consume the content, produce the content. Shit out the content, eat the content. Content, 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 content. I'm a content machine. I produce shit on a machine. And I'm a content machine. The Witcher 3 next gen upgrade is here. This is my Witcher 3 next gen review. I hope you enjoy this video, my sinners, my disciples. If you're new to the channel, which is highly likely, go down below and subscribe. Join the channel, subscribe, become a disciple, join this amazing growing community today, and check out my music on Spotify. I would appreciate it. I make synth electronic music. So in this Witcher 3 next gen review, okay, the upgraded version of the game, I'm going to break down what you get, the negatives of it, if there are any negatives, and the positives, which are mostly positives. So let's get into it. So the Witcher 3 next gen review, here we go. So this is coming out on PS5, Xbox Series S, and Xbox Series X, okay? And this update includes all of the DLC provided in the previous version of the game, which is great. So stick around until the end of the video because I have some quite shocking news that is different compared to the original version of the game, which some fans might be upset about, I don't know. So the Witcher 3 next gen upgrade includes new animations, it includes new armor, and it includes the Netflix armor, which is pretty cool. If you're a fan of the Witcher 3 Netflix series, then this actually has a new quest in which you can go and get the armor set that you see in the show. So that's a nice little callback to the Netflix and the Witcher show. And I appreciate it. And I also appreciate all DLC is of course included. And the DLC of this game is incredible. Blood and Wine is just amazing. So what do you actually get in the Witcher 3 next gen version, okay? Well, you get more graphical detail, of course, that's not surprising. But what does that mean? Well, it means the vegetation here is overloaded, okay? It's absolutely breathtaking. You see so much more detail with the foliage, the pop-in, all of that kind of stuff is massively improved. And the texture quality has, of course, been enhanced. And for you pretentious game artists out there, you actually get a camera mode, which is great, so you can take all kinds of beautiful shots of Ciri and her features. Mod support is also enabled with the next gen upgrade, which is great, so it's not just PC players, some of it is actually included within this upgrade, and you will have support for mods, which is a plus, okay? Take note, developers and corporate scum, okay? This is how, sorry, but I was just so pissed off at Rockstar and other developers who are so greedy, and this is coming from CD Projekt Red, who are great developers, but they did mess up on Cyberpunk, so they can't be fully trusted, but I feel like they're trying to correct their mistake here by doing this the right way. And what I mean by this is the Witcher 3 next gen update or upgrade, whatever you want to call it, okay, is free. For people on PC, it's just a new update and it's free. And for people who own the Game of the Year edition on PS4 or Xbox, then this is a free upgrade to the next gen consoles, which is just, this is what it should be. It's not like Rockstar, the scumbags that they are, trying to charge, you know, full price for a slightly enhanced graphics. And to be honest, The Witcher 3 next gen has done way more with its next gen capability than Rockstar did with GTA 5. They barely added shit and they expected you to buy it at full price, which is just insulting. And gamers need to make a stand because the gaming industry now has become so poisoned, so corrupt. I talk about it all the time. And there are so many vicious practices now. You know, it's not only games that have gone up in price now. By the way, they've gone up to like $70 or something instead of $60, but there are also always ways of monetizing them within the game itself, which just takes out the whole experience, especially of single-player games. I mean, just look at Assassin's Creed now. It's a goddamn joke. So we need to fight back, otherwise the gaming industry will become a complete shit show where consumers are being teabagged by the big studios, okay? Oh yeah, look at this, baby. This is Witcher 3 next gen. This is what I want. This is the graphical status that I expect. This is how you do it. It's a free upgrade, and it actually adds a lot to the game. Not only are the textures and the graphics improved, you know, the quality of lighting, not just this, but the camera angle here is also changed, which is great because I had a problem with The Witcher 3 when it first came out, and that's because it made me feel disconnected from Geralt, and the camera was just too far away. This time you can customize, it just gives you so much more customization, it's amazing. You can customize the camera angle, the controls have also been tweaked and you can change them, which is great. And this is something that I have to stress is massively important and a great thing that they added. And this should be a gold standard for all open world games, okay? Because if you're like me and you care about immersion, you fucking hate minimaps, okay? I hate them. I hate them with a passion. No, I seriously hate minimaps. They take me out of the game. I love Dark Souls and Dark Souls 2, especially because the HUD just fades away when you're not using it. That should be how all open world games are done. Customizable HUD elements, where if you're not using the goddamn thing, hide it. I don't want to see that shit, okay? Unless if I have to. You know, for Witcher 3, I tried playing it without the HUD when it first came out, and it's pretty impossible because you have to keep going into the menu to look at the map, and the load times were just annoying. This time, you can have customization over the HUD options, the minimap, if it just disappears or if it's completely gone, or if you can only see it when you want to see it, which is how all games should be, in my opinion. You know, they just have so many more options with the HUD elements. You can choose what you want to see, what you don't want to see. You know, the camera angles, like I said, is a big plus. Photo mode and all that stuff is just so great. So this is a great upgrade, okay? And it's free. So this is exactly how the gaming industry should be done, and this is what developers need to be doing moving forwards when they are porting over older games. If you do enjoy the content here, make sure that you give it a like, give it a little love tap for me, and subscribe, like I said. Consider donation on PayPal. That's how you can support an independent creator like me. So like I said at the beginning of the video, there is one change which fans might be upset about, and that is they have changed the look of some of the characters, especially the female characters. Nothing major, and it might be because of the modern times that we live in, but I'm pretty sure it's just, you know, a texture enhancement, and they just ironed a few things out. But some people have noticed that they don't look exactly like they did before. I wouldn't say they look uglier, maybe just more realistic, but that's just something to take note of. And of course, this runs at 4K 30fps with ray tracing enabled for Xbox Series X and the PS5, and it is 60fps and lower resolution if you want it on performance mode or if you're on Xbox Series S. And yeah, it's a good time. This is a great way to experience The Witcher 3, you know, with new textures, new color correction, new details, and the foliage does add a big impact to the game, in my opinion. It adds to the immersion, because in the original, a lot of it felt very samey with its, you know, kind of forest look, but now you get lost in the, you know, the deep foliage, and I just feel that is just more immersive. I hope you enjoyed this Witcher 3 next gen review, and I hope I gave you enough detailed information in my review of the Witcher 3 next gen game, upgrade, update, whatever you want to call it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, like I said, please subscribe, join the channel for great gaming content, retrospective gaming content, new game reviews, and all kinds of content, from music to philosophical videos to tearing down the goddamn corporations and the establishment. Make sure that you do subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day. Peace out.